Hey there, Pete Moriarty here. Welcome to our channel. If you are new here, we help entrepreneurs systemize, organize, and scale using Google Workspace and other best practice technology tools. And today I am going to be reacting to an article that some of our friends at Chrome Unboxed have released called Five Improvements to Google Keep to make a better note-taking and journaling experience. Now, we've been working with Google Workspace for over 10 years now. Google Keep is obviously a part of Workspace now. And so I'm gonna be talking about, I guess, from the perspective of a business owner and an entrepreneur, considering we represent hundreds and if not thousands of entrepreneurs, both as customers and in our wider audience on our channel as well. So let's have a read of this article and see what is up. So let's go through. I love these guys at Chrome Unboxed, by the way. They've been writing about the Google ecosystem for a long time and we love what they do. So this article is written by Michael and he says that he's been using Google Cursive right now, which is, I didn't even know about it. It's like a standalone app for writing and drawing and creating notes. Looks like a bit of a ripoff of OneNote, but yet it's separate to Google Keep. Now, Google Keep does give you the ability to handwrite notes into there, but I've found that pretty average, mostly because I was actually using it on my Chromebook, and that Chromebook was, even though it was a pretty good device and had a decent stylus, it was just a little bit kind of slow to the touch and a very different experience to the smoothness of, for example, an iPad Pro with Apple's Pencil, which has just absolutely stellar input, very little lag, and great, you know, like, you know, palm canceling and that kind of thing. That's it. Let's come back to Google Keep. And so Michael's use case here pretty much is using Keep for handwritten notes. And so let's see how we go with this. Okay, so wish list number one is better handwriting to text conversion. Here we go. Interesting that he has mentioned Chromebooks have been pretty average because of poor palm rejection. I agree. And here we go. When you try and convert, it's pretty atrocious at converting text to, or handwriting to actual text. I agree. Every time I've tried to, you know, use handwriting tools with Google to text, I've just found them average at best. And so I find myself either typing on a computer on my laptop, that tends to be my primary device, or using voice notes via my phone to have, you know, input actually automatically dictated and then turned into text that way. But what that doesn't do is it doesn't save me when I want to make notes. Let's say if I'm sitting in a meeting or if I'm, you know, at a conference or a workshop or something like that, I don't find myself actually, you know, writing things in, because that would mean I'd have to take a separate device. Like, I use my Chromebook as my primary device because I enjoy typing notes into Asana, which is the main place that I put notes to keep them nice and organized, because I don't want to have to like lug around a second device with my iPad to write in it. It just doesn't really go that well. Okay, number two on the wish list here from Michael is better templates for productivity and flexibility. I don't know where this ruled lines comes from, but that looks like some other kind of service. We can see here he is asking that there should be more page templates because writing just on a dot graph is limitless and fantastic. Okay, interesting. But dedicated design for different needs would make notes cleaner and faster to execute on a pinch. This seems to be a subset of our culture that I'm just so disconnected from, is those who are really, really into writing notes and actually writing them on hand. Personally, I used to use notebooks and I did like the very, you know, somatic experience of writing things as I was, you know, like scratching the felt tip on the paper. Yeah, and that certainly did feel satisfying. But I think my very logical brain actually prefers to format things into text. And so that's why I find myself typing notes into Asana typically, and, you know, actually typing them in with a keyboard. Now, the other thing is I enjoy typing because that tends to be the way that I retain information. And the thing that I like about using a tool like Asana is it's very structured. And what that means is that I actually create a structured and logical frame of my different notes. For example, I would have one note for all of my board meeting notes. And anytime I do either a sync with the board of directors in our business, or if there's a more formal board meeting, I have all of those notes in that one task. And so there's a sequence, there's dates, I can hyperlink between different tasks, all of those features that are not really available if I'm just writing in pages. Myself, I tend to find that I will lose information. And so if I am just, you know, writing on a piece of paper or a notepad and then, you know, it's just hidden away in my notes, I'm probably never going to go back to it because I'll probably forget about it. Yet when I have a sequential, you know, list of all of the note entries, then I find myself just naturally scrolling back past them, and that refreshes past notes for me. That's something that's pretty unique to me personally, but something that is certainly helpful. Okay, so next up is swipe gestures for rapid notes management. Ability to swipe between notes, swipe left to delete them and right to archive them. That would be pretty cool. I think that kind of feature would make Google Keep a little bit more like what we get in Gmail, you know, where the Gmail app is very much designed to be able to quickly triage through your emails. And so something like that in Google Keep would be pretty cool. Okay, so the interesting thing is, you know, the ability to turn off swipe so someone will stop accidentally archiving their notes. I agree with that one. I find myself swiping, or just as I'm scrolling through lots of notes in Google Keep, accidentally archiving things by swiping. Now, I've got a lot of notes that are pinned and they basically sit at the top of my Google Keep. And as I'm trying to scroll through them, I tend to find that if I don't scroll straight, I can accidentally archive them. So that's certainly a bit annoying. Okay, wishlist number 5 is a scroll lock button for better palm rejection. And so that probably sounds like a good idea. I tend to find myself, if on the off chance that I have used Google Keep for writing, I have found that my palm can kind of like disturb the canvas and move it around a little bit. I find that happens with the Jamboard app as well, actually. So certainly can understand that it would be a good idea to be able to pin that in one place. Now, this is a pretty good article from Michael. This seems to be mostly focused on writing and the particular use case of using it for written notes. Myself personally, I use Google Keep on my mobile phone for absolutely everything. I'm using it for screenshotting receipts for important things because the image search actually searches into your images and allows it to pull text out of that, which is very cool. So great for receipts and warranties and those kind of things. I also use it for snapping things like my personal travel documents. I've got, you know, a copy of my passport and birth certificate and all those kind of things in there. So if I ever happen to lose physical documents while I'm traveling, I've got a digital copy of everything there. I've got a digital copy of my licenses. And they're the kind of things that have got me out of trouble where I've maybe left my wallet at the office once and a policeman pulled me over for speeding. And thankfully I had a digital copy there and I was let off, which was very nice. And so I love Google Keep for being able to just quickly jot notes and information down into there. But because it's unstructured, I find that I don't really use it for any structured information that I might use something like Asana for. You know, if I need to delegate a task to someone, that's going in my task management. If I have, you know, sequential updates over time, I'm going to put that in some kind of thread somewhere else to get access to that as well. Okay, I thought we did 5, but maybe I missed that. There's another one here, which is Calendar View, another wish list, Calendar View for journal entry notes and Google Photos linking. You know what? I like this one. That sounds like a good idea. And so being able to, you know, see calendar inputs on when certain notes have been created, again, more useful for someone who uses more notes as a general day-to-day note taking than what I use it for personally, but also linking to Google Photos would be cool. I don't know exactly what you would use that for. I certainly know that you can, you know, add individual photos into Google Keep Notes if you want, but I do find that it can get a little bit slower on the search from time to time if you've got a lot of data in there. And, you know, when I open up a new device and it's got to like download the cache again, you know, it can also slow down things too if there's a lot of images tied into notes. There we go. So there's the article. If you enjoyed this kind of reaction video, please let me know. Head along to Chrome Unboxed, subscribe to those guys if you haven't yet already. They've got a great YouTube channel as well. We love those guys. And if you are new to our channel and you want to learn more about Google Workspace, please make your way around. Give us a thumbs up. If you like this content, make sure you're subscribed. If you're an entrepreneur or business owner and you want to learn more about Workspace, and if we can help you out with anything in your business, you know what to do. Make sure you get in touch. Links are down below. And we also have a pretty awesome transfer in offer where if you transfer your billing across to itGenius, you get a bunch of free perks like training, like support, and a free account check as well. So don't miss that. The link's right down below. And I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Cheers. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you enjoyed this content. And if you need more help with your Google Workspace account, there's 4 ways that we can help. Number 1, join our free community group where others in the community help support each other with their Google Workspace accounts. And I'm in there from time to time answering questions as well. Number two, take advantage of our free transfer in offer to get a bunch of additional value for your Workspace account just for transferring your billing over to itGenius. Number three, you can take advantage of a free consultation if you qualify, or an IT systems check and audit for everything technology in your business. And number four, if you need help right now, you can either join our concierge program or book a one-time fix-it service to get support from our professional support team for everything Workspace and the Google ecosystem. See you in the next one.